Once we're done mapping the field of the coil, we're ready to start using the coil to measure the current. So we'll turn everything down and off. And to have more fine control over the current that we're putting through the coil, we're going to add in a voltage divider box. So this is a gray box that has a multi-turn pot, and it also gives us the ability to reverse which direction the current is. So start with your gray box turned all the way to zero. It's a 10-turn pot, so you'll have plenty of fine tuning that you can do. Unplug the wires from the Hamden and go into the red and black ports on the front, and then take the output of the Hamden and actually plug it into the back. So from black to black, red to red. And so now this voltage dividing box is in between the Hamden and the coil. You'll want to use a ruler to measure the separation of your coil. Think about what that separation means in terms of having finite width. You're going to have to justify that in your report. And then add your compass into your coil. Now, we're using the magnetic field of the coil, which you've mapped out and shown is along that central axis, to deflect the compass needle from north. So compass needle's pointing this direction, we're going to deflect it slightly and then slightly the other way using the field of this coil. That means we need the planes, the face of our coil, to be lined up with north. So once you've got your compass in there, you might have to adjust, turn it so that the plane is exactly in line with north. And then you can rotate this base underneath the needle so that the needle starts at zero. If you want, you can put in a ruler to kind of line up there and help you see where the needle is exactly pointing. All right? Then turn your Hamden back on, drop the range down so you can get a more sensitive current measurement. Ramp that all the way up. You'll notice I'm not really seeing any current yet. Turn that to positive, and then you can slowly increase the current that you're measuring by increasing how much voltage is going to your output signal. And so you've got a nice fine tune there. You'll ramp this up until you see a 20 degree deflection from your original north. Watching the current climb, seeing that deflection in the needle. Again, you can use the ruler there if you want to get a more accurate line. You're shooting for plus or minus a degree in terms of how well you've aligned it. All right, you'll measure the angle, you'll measure the current, and then the nice thing about the voltage dividing box, it actually allows you to switch, and so now we can send the current through the other direction, and instead of the coil pushing the needle that way, now it's pushing it that way, it'll settle down onto a new angle. It might not be exactly the mirror image. We might not have exactly the opposite current. Record that new current. Record that new angle, and then increase it. You're going to go after 20 degrees, get it up to 30 degrees, let it settle down, measure the new angle, measure the new current, switch it back to the other side, measure the current and the angle on the other side. Then, once you've gone through all of that, you can power everything down, You're gonna go 20, 30, 40, 50, 60 degrees on both sides. When you're done, turn that all the way back to zero, turn it off, ramp that down, turn it off, turn that off, and then disconnect everything and leave it neatly for the students in the next lab section.